Peace, love, and blessings. It's your boy Big Truck here at the King's Table. If you haven't already, please show your boy some love. Subscribe, comment, like, and share. Without further ado, we're going to wrap a taste on this. Shit's getting real thick in Dalton. Peep this out.
Its energy surrounds us, embodies us. Luminous beings shall be, not this crude matter.
Information that came directly from the bank, and the guy's name is Nathan Colvin, that stated that Tangemeke Miller, Keith Freeman, and Janice Johnson was on the bank account and can see the information from Fifth Third Direct. Then y'all have Lacey get up here and say that the clerk and Jason House was on the bank account, and that's how the mishappened of the repercussions. This is about the bull crap stuff that y'all see here and go through, because Janice Johnson is the one that issued the check. Y'all so big on throwing each other under the bus, y'all don't even know what y'all be saying. Janice is the one that issued. So Janice, you telling me because somebody switched names on there, they stopped the ACH, they didn't stop the ACH on the Tahoes, they didn't stop the ACH on those electric bikes, they didn't stop the ACH or anything else that been provided, they didn't stop the ACH or credit card on $17,000 worth of skates, they didn't stop the ACH or debit card for anything else. So you get here and sit here and say these things, and you don't have a clue on what you're talking about, but now we're about to go downstairs and probably borrow $30,000 for a lawsuit that you could cover. You don't do that to us. It's not fair. It's not fair at all. And we should have to kill him and keep sitting listening to this call. Then Tangemeke just said the $19,000 that y'all about to approve is on the warrant list. Of course, that bill is from August. Who the hell want to see Tiffany Pitcher all around town? 122 banners. Ain't nobody going to pull that. And Trusty Brown, please tell them what those banners say. It ain't even about her picture. Please read up what the banners say.
Thank you, Trusty. Thank you, right here. A lot of jealousy and envy, that's the shine. But go ahead, Coach, keep calling around. Hey, I told you. Shit's getting real thick over there in Dalton. She throwing heat rocks. She throwing flames. She putting it out there. She's exposing it. It's just like when you expose someone and you let it be known this is your intentions, you notice how they respond. As always, you already know how the response is going to be, how the behavior is going to be when you expose someone for the things that they do and say. Watch out for Jason House. Jason House is going to be the one that's going to take Tiffany Hinge's spot. Watch what I tell you. However, shout out to, I'm going to leave a copy of this in the description, and y'all can watch the full video itself. Just going to wrap a taste a little bit, talking about how when you have the wrong person in position, shit can go left on any given Sunday. It can go bad for you. But when you have the right person in position, a whole lot of stuff can run smooth. You catch me? We're going to get...
The white philosopher. When he said the dreams are like repressed desires of the things that we wish we could have.
You're not a doctor. Are you a doctor?
No, I'm not a doctor yet.
Yet? How close?
a dissertation.
Ooh. I don't even know what that means, so it gotta be close. So, Trustee Belcher, go ahead and tell us about your beginnings with becoming a trustee, or being a trustee, rather, and your beginning your relationship with Mayor Henyard.
I've known Tiffany since about 2012. Mayor Henyard since about 2012. I was asked to run on her ticket in 2021, along with Trustee Jason House, the clerk Allison Key, and there was another person that was on our ticket, Kevin Bowens. We ran, we won. This is my third year, going into my fourth year, so first term. And it's been quite a ride.
All right, Laura, let me get one of the tough ones for you out of the way.
Okay, I'm ready. I had to prepare for you today. I even took a nap.
I promise, I have kid gloves, I promise. Okay, so I gotta ask, when she was trustee, came of the whole alleged slumlord thing with her. Did you guys know about that at all?
You come right out with the questions, huh?
Mold, water leaks. Nearly 3 months ago, we first exposed serious problems in a South Suburban rental home owned by a Dalton Village trustee.
Since then, the renter says it's only gotten worse. CBS 2 political investigator Dana Kosloff has also learned that trustee is pocketing tens of thousands of your tax dollars for a house that's now unlivable.
Ask me, you know I couldn't be much help. Because a friend's somebody, you judge for yourself. Some are okay and they treat you real cool, and some mistake your kindness for being the fool. We like to be with some.
House even passed a village inspection. Issues abated, notes Inspector Brian Thigpen in this September report. Except they weren't.
It's horrible.
Enter activist David Lowry, who called Dalton directly. Suddenly, the house deemed livable on September 3rd became unfit for occupancy on October 15th. Lowry's theory?
The trustee used her power and influence.
We caught up with Henyard before last week's board meeting. I want to talk to you about that house on Dearborn. Can we do that?
My attorney's right here, so if you've got any questions, I have legal counsel.
So you want me to talk to your attorney and not you? You can't tell me how that house failed an inspection in October when it just passed it beforehand?
If you have any questions, talk to my attorney.
So we did.
The inspection process is within control of the village, not of the trustee. She has been instructed by the village attorney to be treated just like any other property owner.
Dalton's attorney says the house's inspection history is under investigation. And village records show a slew of past problems, with the house passing, then failing, then passing inspections for years, even before the Housing Authority of Cook County approved it as a rental property eligible for government housing assistance money, or Section 8. An HACC employee says as a landlord, Henyard's received $36,866 taxpayer dollars in Section 8 rent payments since 2017.
Yes, we were aware of the issue with the mold in the house. We were aware of it. And
What did she tell y'all?
It was a lot of loopholes in it. I'm being transparent. It was a lot of loopholes.
Had you been practicing on your art, you know you're wearing a dog.
It passed the test. So if it passed the inspection through the village and through Section 8, it was kind of questionable. So it was a lot of things in there that could have been like, okay, this is just to kind of push a campaign through.
Okay.
So
okay.
Campaign tactics.
Okay, because, right, of course, I'm not looking for no specific answer, I just want the truth, I promise you.
Yeah.
I'll take it as it comes, because, like, with her events, okay, so the events that she do throw, so I know the reason she be doing that or whatever, you know, trying to, you know, hide other things, but are the events themselves at least good?
When we talking about the events that she be doing and talk about all that other crap, my whole thing is this here. What's in the dark's gonna come to light. You feel me? What's in the dark's gonna come to light. And there ain't nothing else you can say or do about it. When I say the shift is about to take place, watch out for House, Mr. House. He gonna take Tiffany's place. And Queen right here, she gonna be right by his side. Everything has a turning point. Right now, the water's boiling. The pot is about to turn over right now. It's like minutes, seconds away from being turned over. Until next time, one love, Shalom.